My dad suffered from COPD. So getting COVID didn't, you know, obviously it made it worse. And being almost 3 weeks with this cough and struggling with breathing, by the time they brought him to the hospital, it was too late. My dad is Carlos DeLeon. He was the first inmate in DOC custody to die of COVID in Connecticut. He was locked up and he kept calling home. And every time he called, he spoke to my aunt. And he started to tell my aunt how they put someone in a cell with him that was sick. And he wasn't sure what was going on at that time. My aunt was the one who told him what was going on. And she said to him, you know, we're out here and we're unable to really maneuver. Like, we have to wear masks, you know? Are you wearing a mask? And he said, no, no one is. I've been asking them to take me to see a doctor, but the way that they do things in DOC care is that you put in a request, which is a written request you put in. And once that box is, you know, retrieved and the requests are looked at, then someone determines whether or not you're sick enough to see a doctor. And sometimes it could take a week, sometimes it could take 2 weeks. And in my dad's case, he was 3 weeks not feeling well and sick and kept complaining. And I remember one of the last calls that I remember him talking to my aunt and saying, I'm putting in these requests and I'm not getting no call. Like, they're not bringing me to the doctor. They're not bringing me. I'm gonna freaking die in here. That rings in my head. And ultimately, that's what he did. He died. I didn't get to see him. I saw him through a video that one of the nurses was so kind to give us a FaceTime. And I was able to see him laying in the bed with the tubes and, you know, I just asked him to please wake up and to fight, you know? It felt weird because it was through a video and not actually being there. I think that it's so important for someone that's going through that. No one should die alone. No one should die alone, especially for something like this. You know, it's so scary. I myself suffer from anxiety and panic attacks. And I know how I feel, like I'm gonna die sometimes, even though I know it's gonna pass. At that moment, you're not rationally thinking. You're just thinking, oh my God, I'm gonna die, I can't breathe. That thought sits with me when I think of seeing my dad in that bed with those tubes in him. I thought that he was gonna get through this because he's so strong and he's gotten through so much, but COVID did him in. He didn't have a fair chance to fight, you know? I think maybe if the first week he would have been brought to the hospital, maybe they would have been able to get him under control and stabilize him, but that wasn't the case. You know, we sometimes, as adults, look at our childhood and we think, oh, if only mom or dad would have been there more. And then you are an adult and you realize that sometimes we as human beings, we do the best we can with who we are and what we know at the time. So it's, as much as I wanted him to be something else, he was who he was. But he didn't deserve to die alone. He didn't deserve to die like that. Once I found out that my dad passed away, I was caught being told, do you know that they're protesting out here and they're saying your dad's name? And I'm in bed crying. I open up my phone and there's the video. My dad's face on a wooden stick, picture, people yelling, justice for Carlos. the sun coming out. I'm hoping that summer coming, it'll do something. You know, give people the vitamin D that they need and to fight through another year and hopefully not have to keep hearing everything is COVID, 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 COVID. Oh my God. People, we are out here suffering from other things other than COVID. But it's like COVID is life now. I just want people to know that what my dad went through wasn't right. DOC had a responsibility. They had a responsibility to their inmates. My dad, Carlos DeLeon, was their inmate. He was their responsibility. He was not sentenced to death. He was supposed to come home. And they kept him there. And he died from COVID.